We are now on the second part of this 4 video mini-series about biomolecules. In today's video, we will discuss probably the most misunderstood biomolecule of all because everybody hates it, but actually, we hate it because we don't know what it is. I'm talking about lipids, or commonly known as fat. Lipids are a large and diverse group of naturally occurring biomolecules that are mostly nonpolar. So nonpolar means they don't mix with water well. So these biomolecules are composed of molecules that despise water. There are four types of lipids that we will discuss, namely the triglycerides, the phospholipids, steroids, and waxes. Let's get to know each one of them, starting with triglycerides. Triglycerides are lipids which are composed of three fatty acids and a glycerol group. Triglycerides are used by our body as a long-term source of energy. Some examples of triglycerides are fats, oils, butter, and margarine. The formation of a triglyceride happens like this. You need to have a glycerol. A glycerol is a 3-carbon molecule with 3 alcohols in it. So you have 3 hydroxyl groups here. 1, 2, 3 hydroxyl groups. And then you also need to have 3 fatty acid chains. So what you have here is a carboxylic acid chain. So this is your carboxylic acid. And then you have here a long chain of carbon atoms. So these dots represent that the carbon atoms are plenty. Also here and here. So what will happen is the hydroxyl from the carboxylic acid of the fatty acid will be removed, while the hydrogen from the hydroxyl group of the glycerol will be removed. So when these two groups combine, you will have the removal of water. And since this is repeated 3 times in the process of combining glycerol and the fatty acids through condensation reaction, there is a removal of 3 water molecules. If we will remove this group and this atom, what will happen is the carbon will be needing one more bond, so as the oxygen. And again, it will be repeated 3 more times. So what will happen is this. There is now the removal of 3 water molecules, and in order to complete the bond between carbon and oxygen, the 2 atoms will link together, forming what we call the ester bond. So this is an example of an ester bond, and an ester bond. So basically, we have 3 ester bonds in the formation of a triglyceride. And if you notice, unlike the previous biomolecule, which is carbohydrate, triglyceride is a big molecule, which is again composed of a backbone, glycerol, and 3 fatty acid chains. The property of a triglyceride depends on the fatty acids attached on it. Fatty acids can be in a saturated form or unsaturated form. Let's differentiate to using these 2 examples. For the first one, the one up there, your saturated fatty acid is composed of single bonds between the carbon atoms. And when you have this kind of bond between the carbon atoms, what you will have is a straight chain carbon atoms. On the other hand, the one below, what you have there is the presence of a double bond. And when you have a double bond between carbon atoms, you will form a kink or a bend. So what will happen is, instead of having a straight chain of carbon atoms, because of the double bond, that chain bends. And the bend depends on how many double bonds are present. So if you have more double bonds, more kinks or more bends. Less double bond, less kinks or less bends. What is the implication of this? Imagine you have fatty acids, plenty of them. Now, in one group, you have saturated fatty acids. And on the other group, you have unsaturated fatty acids. The group with saturated fatty acids, if you're going to pile them together, the piling will be even because they are all straight chains. And when that happens, the fat becomes solid at room temperature because again, you can pack them neatly. On the other hand, when you have a group which is composed of unsaturated fatty acids, because of their bends and because the kink or the bends can differ from one molecule to another, you will have a difficulty to pile them together. Hence, at room temperature, unsaturated fatty acids are mostly liquid. So which is better for us, saturated or unsaturated fatty acids? Well, since because saturated fatty acids becomes solid at room temperature, unlike unsaturated fatty acids, what we want is a fat in liquid form because our body can easily utilize this kind of fat. My advice is to lessen your intake of fats which are mostly saturated and more of unsaturated fatty acids. There is another group of fatty acid which is basically not natural or commercially made. This is what we call the trans fat or the trans fatty acid. So what is the meaning of this? You see, if you have a double bond, the natural tendency of molecules is for it to bend. But what happens in a trans fat is that bend from the double bond straightens up. So instead of having a cis or a bend form of unsaturated fatty acid, what you have is a double bond fatty acid that is straight. So you call that a trans fat. Now, what is the implication of this and what makes trans fat bad for us? You have learned in your organic chemistry that breaking double bonds is harder than a single bond. So imagine you have a molecule which is straight with a double bond. So if piling of saturated acids makes them solid, imagine how hard it is to break apart a molecule which is straight and with double bond. You can just imagine how difficult it is for our body to break those fat. Now, what are some sources of trans fats? Let's take a look. You have the wafers, biscuits, cakes, cereals, burgers, breads, french fries, pastries, pizza, fried chicken, and a lot more. And food scientists found out that chicken nuggets have the highest amount of trans fat out there, followed by fries, burgers, and the other foods that we can buy in fast food chains. The second type of lipids are the phospholipids. Now, from the name itself, it is a lipid with the element phosphorus, and their structures are shown on the pictures beside me. If you will observe the structures, you will see two differences in them. In triglycerides, you will see the three legs, which are the three fatty acids. While on the phospholipids, you will only see two legs. So that means phospholipids have only two fatty acids. The second thing to look at is the presence of an atom found at the head of the phospholipid, which is the phosphorus. So this is an example of a phospholipid. So a phospholipid contains the glycerol, there you go, and it is attached to two fatty acids. So one is a saturated, the other is unsaturated fatty acid. Now, the other part of the glycerol is attached not to another fatty acid, but to a phosphate group. Now, because this head contains a phosphate, the head becomes hydrophilic head, which means this part of the molecule loves to be with water. On the other hand, the fatty acids or the tails are hydrophobic. It means they hate to be with water. So this biomolecule is unique because of that property, because half of it loves to be with water while the other half hates to be with water. One part is polar, the other part is non-polar. This property of phospholipids makes them unique in creating what we call cell membranes. So a cell membrane, if you're going to look at it in a very powerful microscope, you will see the cell membrane like this. So you have here the heads of the phospholipids and the tails of the phospholipids. So you have here a bilayer phospholipid because you have the first layer here outside the cell and you have another layer inside the cell. So this cell membrane protects our cells in order for water not to invade the organelles in our cell. And that is only possible because of the property of phospholipids. You see, fats are not that bad. The third type of lipids are what we call the steroids. And I know what's in your mind. These are bad molecules. But in fact, they are not. Now, steroids is a unique molecule because, as you can see, it is composed of four rings. The first three rings are composed of six-sided rings, while the fourth ring is composed of a five-sided ring. Now, what is the function of a steroid? Steroids are basically the foundation of creating what we call cholesterol. And again, I know what's in your mind, these are bad molecules. But again, what I'm gonna say to you is, they're not. They're just misunderstood, okay? So cholesterol is a precursor of a lot of important hormones in our body. And not only that, precursor also of vitamins. Now let me give you some examples. Because of steroids, we have cholesterols. And because of cholesterols, we have your estradiol for women and testosterone for men. So these are hormones for men and women. And as you can see, the steroids are located in their molecules. Now, the other importance of cholesterol is, just like what I've said a while ago, it promotes the creation of vitamins. And one important vitamin that is produced via the use of cholesterol is vitamin D. Vitamin D is also called as cholecalciferol. And you see here the structure of the steroid. And again, it is made possible by cholesterol. In reality, our body actually produces its own cholesterol in order for some processes to continue. Like for example, the production of hormones and the utilization of the vitamin D. Too much of cholesterol is bad for us. So which food are high in cholesterol? We have the beef brain, chicken liver, egg yolk, shrimps, cheeseburgers, chicken legs, and a lot more. The last type of lipid are the waxes. Waxes is a combination of a fatty acid and an alcohol. But this time, it's no longer a glycerol which has three hydroxyl group, but only a molecule which has only one hydroxyl group, an alcohol. And you have again the fatty acid here. So when these two combines by the removal of OH and H from each side, you have the removal of water, then you have the formation of the ester bond. So this is an example of a wax, and as you can see, it has only one tail. Waxes are solid at room temperature, and because waxes have only one fatty acid tail, they are less greasy compared to their relatives, which are the triglycerides and the phospholipids. So to differentiate the four lipids, you can use this method. If it has three fatty acids, what you have is a triglyceride. If you have two fatty acids, what you have is a phospholipid. If you have one fatty acid, what you have is a wax. And if a lipid has no fatty acid, then you have a steroid. So that is the second part of this four-part mini-series. If you want to look for the other molecules, you can check the description below, and I'll see you next time.